You've been working a lot with and or now, and the expressions got kind of complicated. In fact, so complicated that they've attracted the interest of mathematicians, such as this stern-looking fellow. His name is George Boole, and he figured out the rules for working with conditions that could be true or false. And ever since, that's been called Boolean logic. Now, why do we care? We want our programs to be simpler to read. And so when we have a long and complex condition such as this one, we might want to put it in a separate method. Let's think about what this test here was. This was the test for the S flag, where you had a blue square in the middle. This test here checked, is our pixel in the middle? All right. So if we had a method that could test that, we could say, if X and Y is in the middle, then we want blue, otherwise white. Much easier to read. Let's go and write this method. Here it is in middle, takes an X and a Y coordinate. And here you have the exact same condition that we've had before, and we simply compute and return that. There's just one catch. We have to specify a return type for this method. And what is this thing that's being returned? Well, it's either true or false. In Java, the type that has two values, true and false, is called Boolean in honor of our friend George. Here it is. So when you have a method that can return a condition that's true or false, you declare it as a Boolean method. Then you can use that method inside an if statement just as much as you can use the relational operators. You would want to do that whenever a condition has become so complicated that you want to put it inside its own method. You can also declare variables of Boolean type. Let me give you a quick example. I've re-implemented the isInMiddle method to use two Boolean variables. Let's check it out. The first variable, xInMiddle, checks whether x is between 1/3 and 2/3 of the width. It's set to true if this condition is fulfilled, or to false if it's not. And similarly, this variable over here, yInMiddle, is set to true when this condition is fulfilled, and to false if it's not. Why might I want to do this? Because each of those conditions is complicated enough that by saving it in a variable, it makes the code easier to read. Now over here, I say if both of these conditions are fulfilled, then the point is in the middle, so I return the AND of these two. Generally, you use a Boolean variable if you want to remember a value that's true or false so that you can use it later. Sarah has an example of that for you in a different context.